Hey guys, it's Stars here. So I'm going to show you how to record a voice bank using Audimo. This is going to be a CV format voice bank. So as you can see, I already kind of started a little bit. The reason why is because I had tried to make this tutorial and realized I left out some pretty important things. So I am going to be using a new microphone for me. It uses one of the box recorders, the Focusrite Scarlett. And then my microphone is a Artist Elite AE5100 by Audio Technica. And this is really hard to use for me because I have to wait a second to start recording. This is just, it's a new microphone I'm borrowing for my father, so it's different for me, and I'm having a little trouble with it. When you're recording a CV voice bank, it's always the simplest format and it's always the easiest to do, and it's a quick run through. It will probably take you about 15 minutes if you are new to it, about 10 minutes if you're not. I've found that I can even record it within 5 minutes if I want to do a rapid voice bank, but that was with my old microphone. This one isn't going to let me do that. As you can see, I have my advanced settings open. This is to enact the target tone so I can see what pitch I'm recording in. As you can see, all my boxes over here are checked. You're going to need them to be checked in order to see your target tone. If you do not care about it, because hey, you're just making a quick utao just to see what you sound like in utao, then you don't really need this. You can just go through quick. When you're recording a CV utao, it's probably easiest for you to just do the hold down the key, the R key. I'm sorry. It's easiest for you to hold down the R key. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to recording style settings and make sure that manual recording while holding R is pressed, is the one that you have selected. There are other formats, of course. Like this one, where but it's easiest to use this stuff for VCV. With CV, if you're just running through, it's the sound samples that are provided are a little bit longer. And I believe they actually are set up for VCV 7 Mora, so it's not really all that helpful when you're recording a CV voice bank. So I suggest just doing the hold down the R key method. So we are going to run through a couple of these sounds. As you can see, I already got to foo. So we're going to start with ga and just keep going through. I'm just going to show you. So you're going to be holding down your R key while recording. If you do have a delayed mic, you're going to want to wait 1 second, like count a second in your head, go one, and then say your sound, because that's what I've been doing. So let's do this. Okay. Ga. That was a little too low because I stopped recording for a little bit, but see how it's how the these blue dots right here are lower. That means that it's not in the range that you want it to be, which is this D4 for me. It looks like it's a little closer to C4. So let's try and pick up the pitch just a little bit. Gah,
Gah.
and if you want to listen to your sample, hit the space bar and it will play your sample for you. Gah. Okay. Gah. That was a little better. All right. I'm not going to try and get directly on pitch. This is a quick run-through bank. In order to go to your next sample, just hit the down arrow key. No, gaming keys will not work. You cannot hit the S key. It will not go down if you hit the S key. If you are wondering what these little arrows are right here, these are basically like adding a suffix to your sample. Older voice banks used to use these arrows in order to record, to present as a pitch up or a pitch down. So these were kind of used with the original tri-pitch voice banks. Now it's not as often used. Most people just use the key as their suffix and then they edit the prefix. I mean, not the prefix. Well, yes, it's a prefix map. They edit it to play the sample. So we're just going to go through a couple of these samples for you. Not that many though, just so you can get an idea of how recording a CV voice bank goes. So here we go. Yeah. Key. Go. go. Yeah. Yeah. Oops, I didn't wait long enough. Yeah. Yo. You. So, as you can see, I'm pretty close to my target range. It's okay if you're like within these, like, if you have it set up like mine where your bars are really close up, like you're only one pitch more and one pitch less for your maximum minimum. It's okay if you're just like within these sets of the boxes. This is the direct, like, perfect note right here, but it's very hard as a human being to get a perfectly flat note. You can, it's just not very easy. It takes a lot of experience and practice. I've been doing Utel for 7 years now, and I can't get to be perfectly on the line myself. So, don't be discouraged if you're a little tiny bit out. It's not really a big deal, especially with the consonant parts. Consonants are very hard to get in a certain pitch. Because of the fact that your vowel is what's going to be carrying on. So, like, your T is not going to be in a certain pitch, really. It's not going to go and be like perfectly in pitch. Your main focus is that your vowel is in pitch, and as long as you're keeping your vowel in pitch, your consonant is going to be very, very close anyways. So don't worry and stress out too much about getting it directly inside the line. As long as your vowel is relatively close within these three measures right here. Or three lines. I don't think they're actually called measures. Within these three lines. That's all you have to worry about is your pitch staying in there. It's best to try to get your vowel to be as straight as possible, but I do understand it is not easy for everybody to do that. I even still struggle with it, and I kind of just gave up on trying to make it perfect because it takes me 3 hours to record a VCB voice bank if I try and make every sample perfect. I just try and keep it right within these ranges right here, within these three bars. So I hope this tutorial was helpful for you guys. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.